open your mouths and give God praise. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Glory.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on, let praise flow in this place tonight.
Hallelujah.
God, we worship you. We praise you.
Hallelujah. Glory to your name, Jesus.
We magnify you. We celebrate your name.
Hallelujah. Bless your name.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Before we start with praise and worship, can you just throw your arms around somebody and tell them it's good to see you in the presence of the Lord? Good to see you. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
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 We're going to sing some old Pentecostal apostolic devotional songs, and we want you to join in with us on tonight. Is that all right? Come on, put your hands together. You know the windows of heaven are open, and the fire is falling tonight. I've got joy, joy, joy in my soul, since Jesus made everything right. You know I gave in my old filthy garment, and he gave me a robe of pure white. Now I'm feasting on matter from heaven. That is why I'm happy tonight. Come on, everybody. You know
the windows of heaven are open.
And the fire.
And the fire is falling tonight.
I've got joy.
I've got joy, joy,
joy in my soul.
Joy in my soul.
Since Jesus
made everything right.
You know
I gave him my own filthy garment.
And he gave me
and
a robe.
He gave me a robe of skin white.
I've
feasted on manner from heaven. That is why I'm happy tonight.
One more time. You know the
windows of heaven are open. And the fire is falling tonight. I've got joy, joy, joy in my soul, since Jesus made everything right.
Oh, you know I
gave him my old filthy garment.
He gave me a
robe. And he gave me a robe of new white.
Now
I'm feasting on manner from heaven. That is why I'm happy.
That is why I'm happy tonight. Oh,
I've got joy, joy,
joy
in my soul, since Jesus made everything right.
You know
I gave him my old filthy garment, and he gave me a robe of pure white.
Now
I'm feasting on manna from heaven. That is why I'm happy tonight.
Pray.
Glory, glory,
Oh, come on, clap your hands, all ye people, and shout unto God with a voice of triumph. Church, I love Jesus, for he's my Savior. When storms are raging, he's my shelter. Oh, where he leads me, I will follow. I love Jesus, he loves me. Everybody say,
I love Jesus, he's my Savior.
When storms are raging, he's my shelter.
He's my shelter.
Wherever he leads me,
I will follow.
I love Jesus.
I love Jesus, and he loves me.
Church, I love, for he's my
Savior.
When storms are raging,
he's my shelter.
Oh, where he leads me,
I will follow. I love Jesus, and he loves me.
One more time, say
I love Jesus,
for he's my
shelter.
When storms are raging,
he's my shelter.
Wherever he leads me,
I will follow. I love Jesus.
We will bless that wonderful name of
Jesus.
Come on and
bless that wonderful name of Jesus.
Come on and bless
that wonderful name,
the name of
Jesus.
There is
no other name I know.
We come to bless that wonderful name of
Jesus.
Come on and
bless that wonderful name of Jesus.
Come on.
The name of
Jesus.
There is
no other name I know. There is power in the name of
Jesus.
So much power in the name of
Jesus.
There is power in the name of
Jesus.
There is
no other name I know.
There is power in the name of
Jesus.
So much power in the name of
Jesus.
There is power in the name of
Jesus.
There is
no other name I know.
And we cry, Jesus. There is no other name under heaven can save us but Jesus.
Jesus.
There is
no other name I know.
Jesus,
Jesus,
there is
no other name I know.
Church, we cry, Jesus,
Jesus,
there is no other name under heaven can save us but Jesus. He freed me forever. One day he's coming back. Glorious day, everybody say.
Living he loved me. Dying he saved me. Buried he carried
he
my
sins. He took my sins
far away.
Well then,
by then he justified.
Jesus freed me forever.
One day he's coming back. A glorious day.
One day when heaven was filled with his praises. One day when sin was as black as could be, that's when Jesus came down to be born of a virgin, dwelt among men. Our example is he, everybody say.
Living he loved me.
Dying he saved
me. Dying he saved me.
Buried he carried
me. Buried he carried my sins far away.
Well then,
dying he justified.
Jesus freed me forever.
One day he's coming back, a glorious day.
One day they led him up Calvary's mountain. The day when they nailed him to die on a tree. Oh, suffering anguish. He was despised and rejected, bearing our sins. Our example is he, everybody said.
Living he loved me.
Dying he saved
me. Dying he saved me.
sins
far away.
More than rising, he justified.
Breathing forever.
One day he's coming back.
Glorious day.
Well, then Sunday the grave could conceal him no longer. The day when the stone rolled away from the door, that's when Jesus rose. Over death he had conquered. Now he's ascended. He's our Lord evermore. Everybody say,
living he loved me.
Dying he saved me.
He saved me. Buried he came.
Took my sins
far away.
Well then,
rising he justified.
Jesus freed me forever.
One day he's coming back. Glorious day.
Living he loved me. Dying he saved me. Buried he carried my sins far away. Well then, rising he justified, free me forever.
One day he's coming back, glorious day.
Send it on down, Lord. Send it on down, Lord.
Lord, let your Holy Ghost come on down.
Send it on down, Lord. Send it on down, Lord.
Lord, let your Holy Ghost come on.
Hallelujah.
for a holy people to be his bride soon by and by. He said to us, refreshing water in this wondrous latter day, they who really will be raptured must go through the... Verse 3. Are you on your way to ruin? Come but with a load of care. See the quick work God is doing, so that his glory you may share. At last, the faith he wants delivered to the saints. Ours today to get in the church triumphant, you must go the walk. Verse 4. Have you looked and often wondered why the power is slack today? Will you stay in that number and go on in the man-made way? Old saints who never have been buried in the blessed name of God, let this truth now sanctify you. 'Tis a way. Come on, Zion. It shall be light. The way to glory you will surely find. Through the water, it is the light today. Baptized. Young and old, young and old. And the Holy Ghost. The evening. It is a fact. One more time. It shall be light. It shall be light. The way to glory. Through the waterway. Baptized. Oh, young and old. Repent of all your sins. And the whole. Evening light has come. It's a fact that God. Oh, we're singing one. One way. Oh, there is one. There is one. One way. Baptized. For there is one way. There is one way. Oh, there is one way. There is one way. There is one way. In Jesus' name.
Can we give a shout out for the name of Jesus? Come on, give him praise. God bless you. We're so grateful. We're so honored to be here in the Bible Way Church. We're coming at this time for Bishop Ronald Demery, who's going to give us their welcome and their occasion for this evening. God bless Bishop Demery.
God bless you. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. Certainly we honor the Lord for being here today. I want to thank God for his goodness and his loving kindness. I want to honor the Lord for our apostle who's here, the Honorable Apostle James Silver and Mother Vera Silver. Lady Dimery, just wave your hand. On behalf of Lady Dimery, all of our pastors, their wives, and the entire Bible Way Church family, we welcome you to this Apostolic Pentecostal Fellowship. Amen. How many of you feel welcome? Amen. We welcome you. We are so honored to be able to host this historic event. And I want to pause to give honor and deference to our visionary in the person of Bishop Alfonso D. Brooks. Come on, let's give God praise for him. And I want to praise God for his wife who's here. Amen. Let's give God a praise for Lady Helen Brooks. Amen. To all of these fine pastors, amen, everyone in their respective places, amen. It's good to be here today. Amen. And I'm going to be very brief, and so I want you to know that you are welcome, and we pray that you have a wonderful visit here in the name of the Lord. Now, I have a dual assignment today. My other assignment is to give you the occasion. And the occasion is the purpose, the reason, the cause, the call, the justification, the need, the motive, or inducement. The reason why we're here today is because on the day of Pentecost, following Jesus' death, burial, and resurrection and ascension, the New Testament church was born with great power. The Holy Spirit demonstrably transformed the lives of those believers in the upper room, and God's power carved out a new community in the world, the church. God never intended for the church to begin in power and glory and then decline to empty, lifeless ritual. Certainly, the outpouring of the Holy Ghost on the day of Pentecost demonstrates that the church was born to live in continual flame of revival. The revival in the book of Acts appears to be in a large part facilitated in an atmosphere of unity. The first believers were willing to pool their resources in order to meet the need of the community. They continued together in fellowship, in worship, in breaking of bread, and in prayer. It is evident that the apostolic leaders did not always see eye to eye on everything. However, they were willing to work together to resolve their differences through the assistance of the Holy Ghost. Unity does not mean that we dissolve our unique identities or that we dismiss our opinions. The body of Christ is made of many members, and each member's unique qualities make it function completely. As one writer said, union has an affiliation with others, but no common bond that makes them one heart. Uniformity has everyone looking and thinking alike, but unanimity is complete agreement across the board. Unity, however, refers to a oneness of heart, a similarity of purpose, and agreement on major points of doctrine. We are here today to ignite the fire of Pentecost. To ignite something, it means to set it on fire. It means to cause something to burn. It means to give life to something or to give energy to it. And if there's anybody here today that don't know the reason why we're here to praise and magnify the God of our salvation. We have dropped our titles. We have left our churches. There are no big I's and no little U's. We are all God's children, and we came here today to get a miracle from God. And we're here to worship God. We're here to magnify his name because he's worthy to be praised.
Thank you, Bishop Demery. Thank you for the occasion and the warm welcome that you gave to us. And I say amen. Is there amen in the house? God bless you. This time, this awesome Apostolic Pentecostal Fellowship choir who is singing out of the depths of their hearts. They're going to come and give us a selection at this time. They come from so many churches. Many of the churches are represented here today, and we're so grateful for all of you. And let's give this choir a hand as they come to us. Come on, put your hands together. The blood still works. And because of the blood, we're kept. Thank God for Jesus. Give this choir another hand. You don't hear folk talk about the blood like they used to. But the blood still works. My. When you used to get in a tight and didn't know what to do, the first thing would come out your mouth was the blood of Jesus. Lord, I thank you. Thank God for the musicians. Come on, give God a hand. Supposed to be 300, but it was, you know it's more than 300 up here. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank all of the pastors for being so supportive in this endeavor. In Jesus' name, we're so grateful for the apostolic heritage that we have. We're going to give a partial listing of the predominantly black Oneness Apostolic Churches birthed in the D.C. area. Thank God, because of Azusa Street, this thing starts spreading. I'm so grateful for the patriarchs and those that stepped up to the plate and paved the way for us. Thank God for Charles Parham, William Seymour, Bishop G.T. Hayward, Bishop R.C. Lawson, Bishop Henry C. Brooks, Bishop Smallwood Williams, Bishop James Morris, Pastor Lena Sears, Pastor Amelia Williams. From the years of 1914 through 1935, they made a giant step and an impression and was able to pave the way for the Apostolic Church in this area. Thank God for the patriarchs. Thank God for the patriarchs. We're going to hear comments from those that are representative of the churches that have started, the organizations rather, that have started in this area. Bishop G.T. Hayward, dealing with Pentecostal Assemblies of the World, Bishop R.T.C. Lawson. We want to hear from, I don't know whether Bishop Pendleton is here. If he is not, we're going to hear from also one of the churches that made a great impression in this area, started by Pastor Amelia Williams, and Bishop Ramsey Butler was the man of God who carried on that work. And we're going to hear representing Greater Morning Star Church. Wow, Morning Star is in the house. God bless you. We're going to hear from Bishop Charles Johnson to represent Morning Star. Following him, we're going to hear from Bishop Michael Fields representing Church of Our Lord Jesus Christ. Bishop R.C. Lawson, founder. Following him, Bishop Henry Brooks of the Way of the Cross Church. We're going to hear from Bishop Alfonso Brooks. We're going to hear from Bishop Dempsey in reference to Bishop Smallwood Williams, Bible Way Church. Bishop James T. Morris founded the Highway Christian Church of Christ, and Bishop Herman Jenright, we're going to hear from him to represent. Pastor Lena Sears, who Church of Jesus Christ, we're certainly going to hear from Bishop John Leslie in that order.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Somebody shout hallelujah. Amen. We give honor to the Spirit of Christ and Bishop Brooks and Bishop Demery and Bishop Leslie, all of the bishops. But I just want to say this was outstanding. Great vision. I was going to Chicago and I talked with Bishop Davis up there, and he was talking to me about how they and churches in Chicago got together on Pentecost Sunday. Bishop Davis and Bishop Bell and the other churches there. And I thought that would be a good idea, but you put the groundwork to it and got it done, and we thank God for it. Amen. How many are glad that you're here? Amen. And I thank God for our heritage. I believe that if the fathers could see us, they would be happy to see us together like this. Amen. I believe that. I thank God for Pastor Amelia Williams, who started the church, and then shortly after she passed, and Bishop Ramsey, Nathaniel Butler, took over, and he pastored for 51 years. And I thank God for my heritage. And I want to say I'm glad that I'm apostolic. Praise the Lord. I said, I'm glad I'm apostolic. I want you to know that. I don't take down. I'm not taking down. I'm not going to compromise. I'm telling you that. Hallelujah. The choir sang 111. And I believe that. And so I thank God for this great opportunity. I know I got 3 minutes and probably got about 30 seconds left. And so I want to thank God for this opportunity to stand here and be here tonight and be a part of this great occasion. In Jesus' name, God bless you.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Can we put our hands together one more time and give Jesus a wonderful. Give honor to Christ and to all of the people of God, the pastor, the angel of the church, to the visionary, Bishop Brooks, and to all of the people of God. I say praise the Lord one more time. This is the Lord's doing. I said this is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. I'm so grateful to be here fellowshipping with my brothers and sisters. Although we're many branches, there's only one tree. I feel like saying that again. Touch somebody and say, many branches, but there's only one tree. Amen. If we remember that, there'll be no problem with us coming together, worshiping the Lord together. There's only one heaven. There don't be a Bible Way section or a Cool JC section. There's only one heaven. About 97 years ago, a young man by the name of Robert Clarence Lawson, by the leading of the Lord, branched out and started work. Didn't just start a church, but he started a new organization called Churches of Our Lord Jesus Christ of the Apostolic Faith, which I'm a proud member of and have a long history. You think about it, all of us are connected. We're all connected. We don't act like it sometimes, but we're all connected. But he started a movement, and many sons and many daughters have branched out, which I'm a part in. I'm happy now. Started in New York, and by the leading of the Lord, ended up here in Washington, D.C., serving the Lord under that banner of Cool JC. But the most important thing about it is that I'm serving God as a servant of the body of Christ. And that is the most important thing. We have a tremendous history, a rich history. And the more you dig, the more you find. How we're all tangled up together, how we all came up together. And although we went our separate directions, the Lord keeps trying to pull us back together. And we need to be mindful of that, because when Jesus comes, he's coming back for one church. I said for one church. Yes. And we all love our organizations. We love our leaders, and we should. Great men, great women who preached the word, who laid the foundation. But when Jesus comes, he's coming for everyone that's a part of the body of Christ. And as proud as we are of our organizations, when we stand before him, he's not going to ask us what organization we were a part of. Yes. And he's going to want to know if we're part of the organism. Have you been washed in the blood of the Lamb? Amen. Have you been cleansed? Have you been filled with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost? Amen. I feel the Holy Ghost in here right now. I can't talk about history without thinking about future. It's the history that catapults us. We have a firm foundation, but I'm looking for Jesus to come any moment now. Back in the day, they said Jesus is coming soon. They said any day now. But I feel like it's any second now. That Jesus, and I'd like to think that when Jesus comes, he'll find his children holding hands, walking together, serving the Lord together. No division, no isms, no schisms, just loving the Lord. Just serving him in the beauty of holiness. Amen. Just look at somebody and tell them, I'm glad you're here today.
We're going to hear a selection by the choir this time. God bless the choir. Thank you.
is built on the thing less than Jesus' blood. And right is righteousness. Say, I dare not trust the sweet, sweetest frame, but holy, holy lean on Jesus' name. When he shall come with trumpet, with his trumpet sound, oh may I then in him be found. Be found. Now open your mouth and say, oh Christ. Christ, the solid rock I stand. I'm standing on that rock. Everything else around it is sinking. Nothing but sinking sand. Oh Christ. Come on, sing it. Let rock I stand. Anybody standing on the solid rock? All of the ground. It's sinking sand. Come on, clap your hands if you're standing on a solid rock. Oh, Christ! If you're standing on Christ, lift your voice with us and sing. He's the solid rock I stand. All of the ground. It's nothing but sinking. It's sinking sand. Oh Christ. Come on, open your mouth and if you're leaning on that Christ, the solid rock, he's the solid rock. All other, there's nobody like Jesus. There's nobody like the Lord. It's sinking sand. I don't care where you go. I don't care what you do. Everything else, everybody else is sinking sand. I don't care how much money you got. Everything else is sinking sand. It's sinking sand. Say you. Anybody know that he is a solid rock? Anybody got to worship in your spirit that Jesus is a solid rock? Anybody know there's nobody like Jesus? Anybody here knows there's nobody like our Lord? We're here to lift up the name of Jesus. Everybody, come on, clap your hands. If you believe God with us, it's sinking sand. It's sinking. sinking, 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 sinking. Hallelujah. Everything else is you're sinking. Yeah. Hallelujah. 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 He's a mighty God, powerful God, awesome God, tremendous God. Nobody like him. Nobody like him. Nobody like Jesus. Nobody, 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 nobody. Thank you, Lord. Sing.
All of the ground is sinking sand. On Christ the solid rock I stand. Everything else is down, sinking sand. Thank God for this. This choir is, my God, they're doing an awesome job. Come and put your hands together for them. We're going to have a liturgical dance by the Agape One Dance Ministry, followed by a gospel, Agape One Church of Christ. I'm sorry. Liturgical dance, Agape One Dance Ministry. Come on, put your hands together for them. I believe our coming together is not just to have church, but I believe God wants somebody chained to be broken. Somebody can receive the Holy Ghost here. The presence of God is in this place. Yes, yes. In this presence, if you're hungry enough, you can receive it while this service is going on. I hear the chains falling. Lord, have mercy. At this time, I certainly want to thank God for those of you that participated and thank God for this opportunity. And I'm going to, at this time, call for the our great man of God that has put us together and brought us together. And it's giving time. It's time to be blessed of the Lord through giving. Giving it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over will men give into your bosoms. Let's receive Bishop Alfonso Brooks as he comes to us in Jesus' name.
God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you so much. God bless you. It's a wonderful atmosphere in this sanctuary today. If you came here without the manifestation of the Holy Ghost, shame on you. It's a gift. Just receive it. Don't push it away. Don't ignore it. Receive it. And the atmosphere and the presence of the Lord in this house, I tell you, this choir is just unbelievable. You think they've been singing together 5-6 years. They've only had 2 rehearsals, and one part here on Tuesday, another part on Thursday. And you could tell that's the anointing to sing like that. And so we appreciate all of you to come, all the pastors that have come. God bless you so much for taking time. I know Sundays are rough on a lot of you. By the time you get out of church, you're ready to go home and just relax. You took the time to come to be with us. I think God is happy that we've come together. And we come to ask you to make a sacrifice, and Pastor Demery is going to come. This is what we're doing this together. And so I'm asking him to come stand with me. I think a lot of Pastor Demery, you know, I had 3 brothers, and all 3 of them are gone. So God gave me another brother. He's my little brother, Pastor Ronald Demery. He's never ignored me. He's never turned his back on me. He's always been there for me. And I just can't thank him enough. I'm going to tell you, he just blew me away. The last few meetings we have a conference, and the hospitality is just off the chain. They fed us so good every time we come. I said, man, you're spoiling me. Now, when I go someplace else, they don't do that. I'm gonna have to rebuke the bad feelings trying to come, because you spoil me. And today, fed all of us that came in, no tabs, no checks, no nothing. Just eat, be happy, go upstairs and have a good time. Come on, put your hands together for the Bible Way Church and Pastor Ron Demery. Beautiful, beautiful. Now, what we want to do, he's going to come and share with us, but the Lord laid on my heart today that there are a lot of requests in this house today. And with all of these bishops and apostles and pastors in here, I believe whatever you desire, God's going to grant it. So if you have a piece of paper in your pocket and a pen, I want you to write your request down. And we'll put a basket up in the front. When you bring your offering, dump your request in. And before you leave, all the pastors going to come together on one accord and speak your blessing into existence. Amen? So if you don't have any paper, I don't know, ask your buddy or somebody to give you a piece of paper. But write it down. Write it down. Whatever it is, trust God. And when you bring your offering, now don't come walking down there with your paper. You don't bring the offering. You know, you need to make a sacrifice. God requires a sacrifice. So, and sometimes it is a sacrifice. Some of the brothers in here today, $50 is not a sacrifice. But to some people, $1 is. And so only you and the Lord know what that is. But Pastor Demery is going to come and speak to us at this time. But we're going to have a basket down in the front when you come down. And he's going to tell you what we're asking the pastors to help us with.
Amen. God bless you. Amen. I'm going to ask our deacons to come. Amen. I'm going to ask our deacons to come. amen, at this time. Now, those of you that are writing checks, make your check payable to Bible Way Church, all right? Bible Way Church, all right? Now, those of you that want to give electronically with your debit or credit card, you can do so, amen, right down front, amen, in the name of the Lord, amen. We're getting ready to give, amen. The Apostle Paul said, but this I say also, he which soweth sparingly shall reap also sparingly. He which soweth bountifully shall reap also bountifully. Every man according as he prospereth in his heart, so let him give, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loveth a what? Cheerful giver. Amen. Now, our visionary has asked each pastor, amen, and all of the clergy, amen, to give $50. Amen. Amen. That's what he asked for. Amen. Amen. He asked all of us to give $50. All right. So we're going to ask you to do that. And those of you that can and will, that will join us, amen, with a $50 offering. Amen. Will you do that? Amen. In the name of the Lord. Amen. Amen. We're asking everybody that can, that will honor the Lord with a $50 gift today. Will you do that? Amen. In Jesus' name. Now, those of you, amen, that may not be able to give 50, get as close as you can to it. Get your best offering. Amen. And stand to your feet. Amen. Amen. Now, let the pastors bring theirs first. Amen. Amen. Let the pastors bring theirs first. Amen. All right, deacons. Amen. All right. Yes, I need a few baskets out here. Amen. All right. Amen. Now, I need a big basket for the prayer request. All right, can y'all get me a basket for the prayer request? Amen. 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 All right. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Deacon? Yes, right here. I need a basket right here in the center for prayer requests. All right. All right. All right. All right. All right. All right. I tell you what, this is what we're going to do. Those of you that have prayer requests, write them and put them on the altar. All right? Write down your prayer requests and put them on the altar. Amen. All right. Amen. 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 All right, now all of our pastors and clergy, amen. Amen. We're going to ask you to, amen, bring your offering. Amen. All right? Amen. Will you do that? Amen. Come on, we're going to lead. Amen. All right. Those of you that want to use your cards, amen. Thank God for technology. Amen. 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 God bless you. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Amen. Yes, sir. Amen. All right. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Amen. All right. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Amen. Let's praise God for the clergy. Amen. Come on, let's praise God for them. Thank you. Amen. Thank you. Amen. Bless you. Amen. 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 Thank you. Thank you. All right, everybody, stand on your feet. Everybody, stand on your feet. Amen. If you would lift up your offering, if you would lift up your offering. Amen. I'm going to ask Bishop Mitchell Way to come and bless the offering. Amen. Amen.
With your offering lifted before the Lord, Father, we thank you, O God, for this that you have done at this apostolic meeting. God, allow every hand that has blessed in the precious name of Jesus, multiplied 10, 20, 100-fold. God, give them the desires of their heart. And if someone does not have the Holy Ghost, fill them even now in the precious name of Jesus. Amen.
Let the church say amen. Now, the two outer sections face the wall. The two middle sections face each other. Follow the directions of the ushers.
Praise. I came to give a glory. Hey, Lord, Yes, it is. My will in the middle of the wheel. Yeah. My hands will praise. My mind will praise. My heart will praise. My feet will praise. Yes, I pray. Yes, I pray. Yes, I pray. Yes, I pray. Oh, when I was down and out, Jesus, you brought me out, and I've got a reason. It's been so good to me when I look back over my life. The many times he brought me out, the many times he kept my mind. Should have been dead, should have been gone. But my God stepped in and let me carry on. My God's been good, and my God's been good, and my God's been good. I want the world to know I serve a soon coming King. I'm gonna praise no matter what the White House says. I'm gonna praise no matter what the government says. I'm gonna praise. You've been good to me. So good to me. So good to me. Yeah, when I was down, down and out, Jesus, he brought me out, and I've got a reason.
Thank you.
on and shout glory. Come on and shout glory. Hey. Woo. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. It's because of the blood. We can hear the chains falling. And we're here tonight, yes, I will praise him. Do you have a praise on your lips? Come on and shout glory in this house. Shout glory in this house. Woo! Lord, have mercy. Woo! You know, I don't mind seeing what my brother done because we still dancing. We just changed partners. Y'all hear what I'm saying? I know some of you are wallflowers and you still wallflower. Much as God has done for you, you can't even muster up a praise. But the writer said, when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he done for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm going to try to behave here, but I got a feeling, a sanctified feeling. I feel him in my hand, feel him in my feet. Woo! Oh, glory. We need a minute of praise break. Is that all right? Take a minute of praise break. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. The doctor told me to take it easy. But I know another doctor. Hey. Y'all hear what I'm saying? I'm gonna leave it alone, but I tell you, I'm glad to be saved tonight. Glad to be saved tonight. Hey! Woo! And you know what? It's not just in church that I go off. Sometime it happened in Bank of America. Sometime it happened in SunTrust. Everybody know me in the bank. I ain't got much money, but they know me there. They said, Mr. Pitts, how you doing? I said, don't you get nothing started here. Because I keep my mind on rewind. Y'all know what I'm saying. Oh. But listen, I'm so happy to see so many sanctified folks in the house tonight. Thank God for this Apostolic Fellowship, Pentecostal Fellowship. With our sisters and brothers, some of you haven't seen in a while. As I heard somebody say, it shouldn't have to be a funeral. Y'all hear what I'm saying? The song was very fitting. The waterway. I believe that's the right way. Well, I thank God for you. I'm gonna move right along as we continue to remember those that set the standard for us. I don't know about you, but I would not be standing here if it had not been men like Bishop Smallwood E. Williams. Oh, God, hallelujah. And old as I am, I still get on the street corner. I know, y'all, you know, you got them new modern cars, you know, airtight. You can't hear nothing on the outside. That's your windows down, you know. But I have no problem standing on a street corner telling it everywhere I go. But men like this that we're remembering tonight, I can still remember when I got saved in the year of 1965. I'm still saved. I was young then, but they call me Pops now, you know. And
I don't like that word too much, but that's what I am. Young boy tell me, I say, come here, let me holler at you. Told him my name, but too many people call me Pops, but that's what I am. Oh man, but I thank God for what he has done in my life. I wouldn't take nothing for my journey. For those that preach the truth, how many in this house believe that holiness is still right? Hey! No sweetheart on the side. Come on here, somebody. Hey. I'm telling you, I ain't gonna get into preaching, gonna tell you, but I'm telling you, my queen is right there. 48 years, I thank God for. I know many of you can top that, but we still in love. And we don't stay up late, Bishop. We go to bed early. Get our rest. All right, let's move right along. We just thank God. Look at your neighbor and say, I'm glad that you're here tonight. Come on, look on the other side and say, I'm glad that you're here tonight. All right. They said something about the new generation scripture showcase. Is that what's coming before me? All right, come on, the new generation. Let's give them a hand. Let's give them a hand. All right.
Unity. How do we live? How do we live? Old Testament. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Joshua, Judges, 1st, 2nd Samuel, 1st, 2nd Kings, 1st, 2nd Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, Job, Psalms, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Solomon, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, Hosea, Job, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi. How do we live? How do we live? New Testament. Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Acts, Romans, 1 Corinthians, 2 Corinthians, Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, 1 Thessalonians, 2 Thessalonians, 1 Timothy, 2 Timothy, Titus, Philemon, Hebrews, James, 1 Peter, 2 Peter, 1 John, 2 John, 3 John, Jude, Revelations. How do we live? Genesis 1 and 1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Unity. How do we live? Acts 2:38. Then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of your sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Acts 2:47, praising God and having favor with all the people, and the Lord at your church daily, such as should be saved. Ephesians 6:1-3, begin. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor thy father and mother, which is the first commandment of promise, and may it be well with thee, and thou mayest live long on the earth. How do we live? How do we live? The 23rd Psalm. Begin. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pasture. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness. For his name's sake. Yea, thou walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I shall fear no evil. For thou art with me. Thou rod, thy staff, they comfort me. Thou art there safe before me. Thou art with my enemy. Thou knowest my head with all. I come alone. I'm going to be a little bit of 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 a little b Unity. How do we live? St. John 11:35. St. John 1:1-3. Begin. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same beginning with God. All things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. Galatians 5:22-23. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. Unity. How do we live? Galatians 5:22-23. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such, there is no law. How do we live? Philippians 4:13. Begin. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Unity. Psalms 19:14. Begin. Let the words of my mouth, meditation of my heart, be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Now introduce yourselves. Begin. We, the youth of the New Beginning, Wells Cross Church family, endeavor to be a shining example of what a good Christian should be. We demonstrate this not just by our words, but by our actions, both inside and outside of church. Because of our actions, those who wear us, we are different and want to be like us. If we come to this church, strive to follow these commandments. We'll not be ashamed to praise God. We'll respect our parents, ourselves, and others. We'll strive for salvation and education. We'll be just decorously and respectful. We'll not pass no talk in church. We'll not gum a candy in church. We'll not play the prayers, scripture, to preach what I ought to call. Will not tattoo our bodies but not our bonds. Will the same sex. Will it by the book. Love, joy, peace, long suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. These are the fruits of the Spirit.
Come on, you can do better than that. Let's give them another hand. Come on. Lord, have mercy. New beginning. They asked me a question. They said, the book of beginnings, I said Genesis. They said, what's the last revelation? That takes care of all of it. Amen. God bless those children. I'm telling you. See, we can train them up in the way they should go, with a whole lot of this foolishness that we see on the street. Got a whole lot of young kids, 8, 9 years old, look like they're 19 with all this makeup and all this stuff. You understand what I'm saying? I'll leave you alone, thank God. But holiness is still right. Whether we like it or not, holiness is still right. Let God be true. Somebody been to Bible class. All right. We're going to continue to remember our apostolic heritage. I'm going to ask Bishop Ronald Denbury to come back and be a representative of Bible Way churches. Amen. Throughout the area, wherever it might be, Bible Way Church, Bishop Ronald Denbury.
Amen. God bless you. Before I get started, there was a Black Ford Fusion, a Merlin tag 9BV77 60, you need to move your car. Black Ford Fusion 9BV7760. I am here today to talk about the Honorable Bishop and Apostle Smallwood Edmund Williams. Amen. And I'm not certain if his daughter is still here. Sister Yvonne Williams, is she here? Oh, she's in the balcony. Let's praise God for her. Is Elder Wallace Williams here? Amen. And right here is the great-grandson. Amen. And now there may be some spiritual sons and daughters. Amen. Of Apostle Smallwood E. Williams. Amen. If you would stand, whether you're Bible Way Worldwide or Bible Way International. Amen. God bless you. Let's praise God for them. Amen. Amen. I'm here to speak on behalf of this local assembly. Bishop Williams was born in 1907. He was, of course, reared by his mother, and they moved to Columbus, Ohio, is where he began his spiritual journey. He was called to preach, and at the age of 16, he was a licensed minister. And at the age of 18, he was ordained the youngest elder in the Church of our Lord Jesus Christ. And at the age of 20, in 1927, Bishop R.C. Lawson sent him here to Washington, D.C. to begin a work in the name of the Lord. And he came here to Washington, D.C. in 1927 with a charge, amen, from his leader and $5. He came to Union Station. Nobody sent for him, but the angels of mercy and grace were with him. He stood at the corner as a street light was his chandelier and the fire hydrant was his pulpit. He declared that you must be saved. He continued to preach on the corner until in 1946, our building next door was erected. 1963, the church grew, and then there was an extension of the mezzanine. But the ministry continued to grow. And let me back up just a little bit. In 1957, at the Pentecostal Ministerial Conference at 1130 New Jersey Avenue, Bible Way Church of our Lord Jesus Christ Worldwide was birthed with Apostle Smallwood E. Williams, Bishop Winfield Showell, Bishop McKinley Williams, Bishop John Bean, Bishop Joseph Moore. And now there are churches all across the country that have the name Bible Way Church. Bishop Williams was not just a dynamic preacher. People would travel here from other countries to hear this man preach the word of God. He preached so until he preached until the church was packed out that he had to build again. And in 1981, this edifice was erected called the Bible Way Temple. But not only did Bishop Williams know that people had spiritual needs, but he understood that people had natural needs. And when there was not affordable housing, amen, Bishop Williams, along with the Bible Way Church, amen, sponsored the Golden Rule Apartments, amen, which are right across the street on New Jersey Avenue. And he was certainly a visionary leader that he did not stop there. He had a vision to build, amen. And in 2004, the Golden Rule Plaza for seniors was built in 2004. But the vision did not stop there. In 2011, Cross, the Saverna on K, hallelujah, was erected. And last year, amen, we broke ground and we opened the Saverna on K. But the vision did not stop there. Bishop Williams said that we ought to have an intergenerational center, a place where both generations can come together. And in just a few weeks, we're going to break ground across the road for Plaza West. I wish I could talk to somebody. Grand Family Units. God is not through with us yet. Bishop Williams served faithfully, was a great preacher. And on June 28, 1991, God called him home. But that was not the end of the Bible Way, because Bishop Williams prophesied that he believed that there was going to be a Bible Way church until Jesus come. He had the foresight and the vision to nominate as his successor the Honorable then Elder James Silver. Who has served this church faithfully. And one thing Bible Way knows through his ministry, that you must be born again. And the ministry still moves forward. At his retirement in 2013, Apostle Silver nominated yours truly as the third pastor of the Bible Way Church of Washington, D.C. Bible Way is moving forward. We still understand neither is there salvation in any other, for there's none other name given under heaven among men whereby we must be saved. We still believe that you must repent and be baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for the remission of your sin, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. God bless you in Jesus' name.
As we move forward, thank God for that. I'm going to ask Bishop Chauncey Brooks Lancaster, would he come to represent the Way of the Cross Church? Give him a hand, just come. And after him, we have a musical selection by the APF Mass Choir.
I just got my promotion. We say praise the Lord to everyone. We just like to say, in a small county in North Carolina, which is called Franklinton, North Carolina, in the year 1896, July the 17th, born to Robert Lee and Francis Brooks, a baby bouncing boy by the name of Henry Chauncey Brooks. God had a plan for him down throughout the years. And sometime during the time of his ridden, he came to the city of Washington, D.C., not following the plan that God had for him. God had to get his attention. How many of you know sometimes God got to get your attention before you do what he wants you to do? But he got his attention, and he decided to accept the call to the ministry. And in 1926, he started Emmanuel Tabernacle. But that wasn't the work. Later on, he was introduced to Bishop R.C. Lawson, Church of Our Lord Jesus Christ. And February the 28th, 1927, starting in the home of his sister, Alice Brooks Johnson, was four members, and they started the Way of the Church, Way of the Cross Church of Christ. And that was February the 28th, 1927. He was later ordained by Bishop R.C. Lawson. Here it is, a young man with a sixth grade education. But the Lord guided him through the Bible, and he was ordained in the Church of Our Lord Jesus Christ. And in the year of 1933, he chartered the Way of the Cross Church of Christ. In the year of 1944 was the first convention of the Way of the Cross Churches of Christ here in Washington, D.C. The move of the Way of the Cross Church continued to grow, and under the leadership and the guidance of Bishop Henry C. Brooks, there started additional churches. We would like to say that the first church that was started under the leadership of Bishop Henry C. Brooks was Ransom Way of the Cross Church of Christ, which was started in Franklinton, North Carolina, which they call the chicken coop. During that time, he had the leadership or not the leadership, but during that time, he had to come back and forth to Washington, D.C., to Franklin, North Carolina, to do the work of the Lord, but he could not go back and forth. So he picked out two sisters that he sent down. How many of you know God can use a woman? They just didn't sit still, but they spread the word. And the only thing that they did not do was baptize. When there were souls to be baptized, they called Bishop Henry C. Brooks to come down and baptize. And then it was also an occasion that he went to Franklin, North Carolina to run a revival. He didn't have a mic, but he was out on the field. And they said that they could hear his voice miles away. It got to the point people were coming from all over. It also got to the point where the Ku Klux Klan did not want him down to preach. So they told him, said, you have to leave, if not, we're going to lynch you. He got word and said, go tell Ahab, Elijah is here. At the time that he was supposed to conclude the revival, he stayed an additional 2 weeks. And because of that, many souls were saved. And his words to the people were, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. He also said in Acts 2:38, repent, be baptized, every one of you in the name of Jesus Christ for remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. He stood on the word of God. He did not take down. He didn't compromise through the word. And to make it short, in the year of 1967, June the 12th, if I'm correct, the Lord called him home. But prior to that, the day before, which is June the 11th, the Sunday night, he was home talking to two of his sons, which is Joseph Brooks and Alfonso Brooks. He told Alfonso Brooks, he said, Alfonso, you're going to build a temple. Sometimes God got to get your attention when you don't want to heed the call. Well, Bishop Brooks did not heed the call. God got his attention. And at this present time, because if he has accepted the call, we are still marching on to kingdom heights and higher heights and deeper depths in the Lord. And we just like to say to you that because of the following of the Lord and inspiration and guidance of the Lord, we are still moving forward. Bishop Brooks have accepted the vision that the Lord has given to him, and he is building the temple. We just like to say the temple is being erected, and we will be marching in very soon. So we just like to say, because of the heritage of February the 28th, 1927, we are still marching on. We will be celebrating 90 years come February the 28th, 2017. Bishop Henry C. Brooks was an icon down throughout the years here in the metropolitan D.C. area. We just like to say there were only four churches, the Way of the Cross, Highway Christian, Morningstar Bishop Butler, and Bible Way. These were the four apostolic churches in the metropolitan area. So we just like to say the Way of the Cross is continued to go forward in the name of the Lord. God bless you.
God bless you as we move right along. I don't want to forget these two honorable preachers here. Bishop Jen Wright will come at this time. Following him will be Bishop John Leslie. Then we'll move with that selection. Then we'll move forward. God bless you. You've been so patient. Thank God for you. In Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Praise Him again. We are thanking the Lord for this privilege and this honor of having bestowed upon me to speak. speak in behalf of the Highway Christian Church of Christ. But first of all, I want to give honor to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and to Bishop Brooks, praise God, and Bishop, all the bishops and elders that are present. We thank, give you honor. And we thank the Lord most of all at this hour for our mentor, Apostle Silver, praise God, a great friend of mine down through the years. We're so happy to be here at this hour. Truly the Lord is blessing us, praise God, to be a part of this great apostolic celebration on this beautiful day that the Lord has made. Many things have been said as I listen to individuals, praise God, saying how they started, hallelujah, and how the churches grow, so, how to prosper so, and we're so happy about that. But we still have a Highway Christian Church of Christ. Hallelujah. And it's good to be able to be here on behalf of it. Because many years ago, Highway Christian Church was counted out. The devil thought he had us. But we are still alive. We are still alive. Hallelujah. And I'm thanking the Lord. We started off under the leadership of Bishop Thomas Morris, or Bishop James Thomas Morris. He started, praise God, under the leadership of Bishop Lawson, as you hear many of the churches did. And he ventured, praise God, here to Washington, D.C., and the Lord laid on his heart to start a ministry, but he wanted, the ministry had to be above Florida Avenue. Praise God, and see, he intended to do just that. He started off in tents and in living rooms and whatever, praise God. But in the year of 1927 is when the church, the Highway Christian Church, was born. And the Lord blessed us, praise God, through down through the years. At one time, Highway Christian Church really flourished. Many churches came out from the Highway Christian Church of Christ, including, praise God, hallelujah, some great leaders that are here today, hallelujah, and whether or not it started under the leadership of Bishop Morris. Bishop Butler, praise God, from Morning Star, hallelujah, and Bishop Douglas Williams, praise God, come out, praise God, from the Highway Movement, and many started, praise God, because of the Highway Christian Church of Christ. And the Lord is still blessing us, praise God. We still have churches. I am the prelate of six churches, pray, that the Lord is still having us over. And we are so grateful and so thankful. I don't find myself worthy of this, praise God, but the Lord knows. Some have said, how in the world are you can be where you are? It's because the Lord says so. I was born, praise God, hallelujah, in Highway Christian Church of Christ, I'm talking spiritually, in the year 1953. I was only 17 years old when Bishop Morris took me down and baptized me in the name of Jesus. Praise God. And I received the gift of the Holy Ghost in the year 1953. And the Lord have kept me saved from then until now. And that's been a long time. Some, like I said, have counted us out, but not so. The Lord said, go ahead. Many years ago, before I was called to the ministry, I was told by the Lord to keep the doors of the church open. I didn't know how I could keep the doors. I was just a deacon. How could I keep the doors open? Praise God. But the Lord blessed me, praise God. At one occasion, praise God, they came to put a lock on the doors of the church because someone had told the commissioners downtown, praise God, that the church had not passed inspection. So they came and they saw, and they were getting ready to close up. But the Lord had me to go down there, hallelujah, and let them to know the church is all right. They sent inspectors and they passed the church. It's all right, hallelujah. And that's been years ago. We are still standing with the prayers and of the saints. You know, the word said, the effectual fervent prayer of the righteous availeth much. I believe that. We are still there because of prayer brought us there, and we are still surviving. I thank the Lord for the old patriarchs that work along with Bishop James T. Morris. Praise God. One of the main members of his first members, one of his members was called Mother Corrine Williams. Mother Corrine Williams had a vision also that the highway would continue to flourish and prosper. And she raised up her children, believing so, and also her grandchildren. And some of her offspring is in this church now, a member of Bible Way. Praise God. I'm so happy about that, because the Spirit of the Lord will have it so that we will not die out. We will live. We will live and not die. We're going to declare the word of the Lord. Praise God. And we thank God for all that has been said and done, and where the churches are concerned, because the enemy wants to destroy, wants to kill, steal, and destroy. But Jesus said, I came that you might have life, and you might have it more abundantly. Hallelujah. Highway may be small, but I'm looking at, praise God, Bible Way. I'm looking at the way of the cross. I'm looking at these other churches that came out just like Highway. And these are our sisters and our brothers. And when something good happened to you, it's happening to us also. Hallelujah. We get happy also, Bishop Brooks. We get happy also. Hallelujah, Bishop Demery. Bishop, praise God. All our bishops are happy with you. Hallelujah. Because the Lord is saying you must live and not die and declare his word. God bless you. Heaven smile upon you. Hallelujah. Pray for Highway. Continue.
God bless you, Bishop Brooks, Bishop Demery, Apostle Silvers. We're certainly happy to be a part of this great service. Did you hear that scripture that District Elder Bonnie Hunter read? Amen. In chapter 2, and verse number 1. You see how the Lord set the church up, but it's a key. You got to dial the right combination. Praise him. I say you got to dial the right combination. You know, when you have a combination lock, you turn, you start at zero, and then you turn to the right, stop at the number, and then you turn to the left and pass the number that you, amen, started off with, and then you turn it back, and then you'll open up the lock. You got to dial the right combination to open up the lock. On the day of Pentecost, they dialed the right combination. Praise him. They were all in one place. They were all on one accord. And they all did the same thing. They praised the Lord. And the power of the Holy Ghost came down in that upper room. Today, we're dialing the right combination. We're in one place. We are on one accord. And all you got to do now is praise the Lord. And if you praise the Lord, the power of the Holy Ghost will come down. I want you to know I got a short fuse when it comes down to the apostolic doctrine. I got a short fuse because I know there's only one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. God bless you is my prayer. Thank you.
services are being recorded. And those of you that want to pre-order tonight's DVD, you can do so in the lobby. All right? After service. Amen? All right. God bless you. We'll be right back.
Do it for me right now. You read the Bible. I know you read the story about the blind man who could not see. But one day he heard was passing by. He said, lay your hand on me. This is what he cried out, Lord, do it, yeah. I know he can, I know he will. You read the Bible. I know you read the story about the blind man who could not see. But one day he heard was passing by. He said, lay your hand on me. This is what he cried, Lord, do it, yeah. I know you can, Lord, do it. Oh Lord, do it for me, Jesus. Yeah, Lord, do it. Yeah, nobody like you. Yeah, do it for me, Jesus. Jesus, yeah, yeah, right now, yeah, yeah, do it for me, Jesus, yeah, yeah, right now, do it, Jesus, yeah. Do it for me, right now, yeah, do it for me, Jesus, right now, hallelujah.
Lord, do it. Do it for me. At this time, I'm going to ask Bishop Gamble, would he come forward to induce our visionary? We're getting ready for the preach word. Is that all right?
Praise the Lord, everybody. Just a quick introduction of our visionary Bishop Alfonso D. Brooks. I'll wait till a few people stop walking. Amen. Thank you. We ready to get to the good part of the service. The singing has been done, but ain't nothing like the word. Come on, celebrate God for the word that's about to come. Bishop Henry Chauncey Brooks and Mother Willie Shaw Brooks must have known it was the Lord's will to continue their family after 11 children, just to have one more. And the 12th and the youngest child, Bishop Alfonso D. Brooks, came into the world December 10th, 1940, with his roots firmly planted in a God-fearing home, baptized in the name of Jesus and receiving the gift of the Holy Ghost. Bishop Alfonso D. Brooks has had a servant's heart all his life. Embracing God's will in his life, in 1967, he began his journey into ministry. In 1969, he was ordained an elder in the Way of the Cross Church of Christ. In 1972, God increased his borders, and he was appointed the assistant pastor. In 1978, upon the retirement of Pastor John L. Brooks, at that time, Elder Alfonso D. Brooks was anointed pastor of the very church which his father founded. Through the years, he's held many notable positions, including president of the National Youth for Christ, chairman of the National Board of Trustees, and chairman of the Pastoral Council. After faithfully serving all former presiding bishops, in 2015, he was elected by his peers and ordained by God to serve as the presiding bishop of the Way of the Cross Church of Christ International. In the nation's capital and around the world, Bishop Brooks is highly respected and admired for the wisdom God has given him to lead. Blessed with a global impact, he is the spiritual father to many churches throughout the East Coast, Alaska, and the African continent. The founder of the Apostolic Christian College and the founder of the Sound of the Pentecost radio broadcast, he's continually sought to preach the transforming gospel of Jesus Christ. Committed to win souls for the Christ, Bishop Brooks desires to establish unity among all believers and through the power of the Holy Ghost to live a life pleasing unto God. Amen. Without any further ado, after this last sermonic selection from the choir, the service will be in the hands of our visionary for the Apostolic Pentecostal Fellowship, Bishop Alfonso D. Brooks. In that order. Thank you.
How many of you recognize that Jesus is a source of all your strength? I don't care how much you lift weights. God can take that strength where you can't pick up a pen. He ought to receive credit for recognizing he's the source of all my strength. I can do nothing without him. Let's put our hands together for the Pentecostal Apostolic Fellowship Choir. You've done an outstanding job. Outstanding, outstanding, outstanding job. Amen. I appreciate all the musicians that take the time to come rehearsal and put the music together. Thank you so much, all of you that have come, and all the pastors that allowed your musicians and your members to come. I thank you so much. I appreciate that, because I know they would not come without asking you, or they should not without asking you. But I thank all of it, and all these pastors up. It just means so much to see all of our brothers. Many I've been knowing for many, many, many years. They still look real young, but they was around when I was young. So I don't know how they do that. But they've been around for a long, long time. And we certainly honor them to come and be with us this evening. And I would be remiss if I didn't take this time to do this. And first of all, I want to thank all the pastors that took the 12 noon prayer. It ended today at 12 noon. We went 10 days straight. And I want to thank everyone that made that sacrifice. And I know it was a sacrifice for many of you, but God honors that. Now, if you have a Maryland tag number eight with A over H 2762, you left your lights on. Left your lights on, so get it. Now, I made that mistake yesterday when I went to North Carolina. We parked at the metro station. I rode the bus and left my lights on. And I got back last night, jumped in my car. It wouldn't even click. It wouldn't do nothing. And I said, oh, Jesus, everybody gone. I'm here by myself. And I looked around, and Pastor Gamma was sitting in the corner. He said something told him, stay there, wait, and make sure I got out okay. And so we called the Lancaster to come back. He came back, but he didn't have his cables. And Pastor Gamma went somewhere, somebody he knew, to get some cables and come back. And then all of a sudden, something hit me and said, you bought this cell phone charger that's supposed to be strong enough to jump a car. Well, I never believed that. I bought a charger, my cell phones. Had three little plugs come out. So I went and I said, Johnson, let's just try this. Let's just try this and see. That little thing is about that big, about 2 inches, no, about an inch and a half wide. And he hooked it up on it and kicked that thing off right away. So I'm going to have to send the news. I'll tell y'all where to get one of them things at. It's not expensive. It'll charge up all kind of phones, but it'll jump your car. I tell you, we're blessed. But listen, I want to do this, and I promise you, because most of the people in my church know I don't do long sermons anymore. In fact, when they were picking the speakers, I said, no, don't do me. Do somebody else. They kept insisting, you do. I said, all right, let's go by what the Lord say. If I get up and say the Lord told me to call somebody else, don't y'all get upset with me, because I don't do. And I know back in the day, Bishop Charles Johnson, y'all had church late every night. I'd ride by Dick Street late at night. They'd be still in church. I'm sure some of the rest of you, I know we did at 9D at 4th and Jenny Avenue every night to late. But now, you don't see that now. Sundays and spoil folk. They want to be home to catch the Redskins or some skin on Sunday evening. But thank God, tonight you made a special sacrifice. And a friend of ours is here. And I want to call her and let her have a couple of words. I don't want the women to think that I discriminated against you, that all the voices you heard tonight were men voices and no woman had anything to say. So Pastor Bonnie Hunter will come and give some greetings at this time. Thank you.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Come on, you can give them a little more than that. Come on, I said praise the Lord. Come on, clap your hands. This is Pentecost Sunday. They made some noise. Hallelujah. You know that God is good, and it's good all the time. And I come to celebrate with the saints of God. Certainly we give honor to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. And I praise God being in this place. I am very humbled to sit among great men. I count it an honor, amen, that God would have me in the right place at the right time. Amen. I thank God because I didn't ask to be what God called me to be. He called me to be. Called me before the foundation of the world. He chose my mom and my daddy. And he used them as a vehicle to get me here on planet Earth. And he didn't just bring me here, but he gave me an assignment. And what about the woman? What about it? Amen. I remember the call on my life. And I was rebuking the devil because I was raised in the church. And I was a Bible way kid. But I was raised in the church and think the women couldn't preach. And every time I get a little high note, they pull my coattail and say, "You ain't supposed to preach. Come on, somebody." And so I was very obedient. Hallelujah. I didn't preach. I said, "Can I just testify?" So every time they have a testimony service, I said, "I got one." Then they asked if anybody else got a testimony. I looked around, ain't nobody got it. I said, "I got another one." And I start testifying for Jesus, and I believe he was smiling down on me. Bless the name of Jesus. And then I had a call, and I said, "Lord, you know, is that you? You sure?" I said, "God, you got to be plain with me because I don't believe in this." But I thank the Lord that it was him. And so when the Lord called me, I would go to some of my men, friends, the pastors and preachers. And I said, "How did the Lord call you?" And they begin to tell me how the Lord called me. I said, "Wow, the Lord called me the same way." Tell your neighbor, he ain't no respected person. Hallelujah. I thank God that I obeyed the call of God. And I'm very honored to be in the place that God has called me to be. And I honor you, Apostle Bishop, Presiding Bishop Brooks. Amen. For just allowing me to say something. Women, we are loosed. Do what God called you to do. God will validate you. You ain't got to push your way. God will make the way. Can I get a witness in here? Do I have any apostolic women? Because we were in the upper room too. When the Holy Ghost came, it fell on us too. Somebody give him a praise. Come on, handmaidens. Come on and give him a praise. God bless you.
Yeah. All right. I guess I'm in trouble again. Yeah. You don't know like I know what the Lord has done for me. Wasn't there. You don't know when, you don't know where. But the Lord has set me free. Now listen, I tell you, I know my time is close. I had in my mind we're gonna be out by 8 o'clock. Just so many things happened tonight. I'm just overjoyed. And a lot of folk don't understand that I am old school. I'm old school. And in fact, when Jen Wright was talking, the church that they have up on 4th and W was where my father started Emmanuel Tabernacle in 1926. And the Lord told him he started too big and made him shut down and go in the house of his sister. And that's where we started the Way of the Cross in 1927. My father was obligated
to Bishop Lawson. He left Bishop Lawson in 1933, but he still honored him. And so did Bishop Smallwood Williams. They honored Bishop Lawson. And whatever Bishop Lawson taught them, that's what they stood on. I got baptized in 1949. I never will forget when I got baptized. The water was so cold, you almost had to break your ice. It was 26 of us got baptized that night. And when I hit that water, it wasn't the Holy Ghost. It was a ghost. And I swung and hit my father in the lip. There's 26 of us, and I was next to the last one, and me and Jimmy Little was tussling about who was gonna be last. And when I saw that blood come out of his lip, I knew I had the Holy Ghost. Or I was gonna be a ghost. And I got happy to come about that pool and thought they would accept that. They said, get on your knees and tarry. You ain't got to fake in the Holy Ghost. Back in those days, we didn't. We had to tarry till your knees ache, your back ache, your neck ache, your ears ache. And we had some very hard rules back in those days. And I was probably one of the toughest pastors in this city. And I got saints here. My social missionary board made skirts, long skirts that go down to your shoes. And any person came in our door with pants on, they were escorted to the dressing room to put a skirt. If they didn't, they had to leave. I was tough. If you didn't have a hat on, one of the ushers would bring you a napkin, put something on your head. If your blouse are cut low, they will go and give you a pin. Y'all ain't hear what I'm saying. Look at your neighbor and say, look where the Lord brought us from. All that kind of carnal ain't saved nobody. All those rules and restrictions ain't saved nobody. I wouldn't let my women come to the altar. I don't care how long the altar line was, my women could not come to the altar to pray over anybody. To the front of the altar, much less up in the pulpit. The Lord started dealing with me. I just want y'all to know I ain't no hypocrite. I want you to know who I am. Because God does not have respect of persons. I'm sorry, it took me a long time to find that out. But the last days, I'm going to pour my spirit out upon sons and. All right, and so the Lord afflicted my body with cancer. I didn't want my wife to know, and she didn't. So he called my baby sister, Olivia. We were so close. And he told Olivia, he said, I'm sorry to tell you this, but he has colon cancer, and we're going to have to operate. And Olivia said to me, Alfonso, what you going to do? I said, I'm not going to do nothing. She said, you have to do something. Let's go tell, you know, some of the people at church to put you on the prayer line. I said, I don't want to do that. So that Monday, it's on the Friday, that Monday, doc said, when you coming in? I said, I'm not going to do it. Father's Day, 1996, I was preaching, and the blood stopped flowing. They took me home, put me in the bed. And my wife said, I got to take the hospital. I said, I'm not going. So they called my doctor friend. We went to Virginia Union together. He came out. When he saw me, he said, you're going to the hospital right now. And so I didn't want to call an ambulance. He took me. And he got there, they said, you got to fix this now. I wouldn't do it. I kept praying and trusting God. And one Sunday, the Lord showed me a sister in the church and said, I'll tell her to come and put her hands on your chest. And I said, Satan, Lucia. The Lord, tell Satan, get out of here. I know the Lord didn't say that. It was a 9 o'clock service, and I wouldn't do it. 11 o'clock, the sister was there. He said, it's just your last chance, call her. I said, oh, man, what can I do? And so I called her. Sister Hodges, the Lord said, if you'd come up here. She looked at me, and she stared at the people. And she stopped at the front. The Lord said, come up in the roster. And you can hear people in the church say, oh. I said, y'all help her up here. And she came up and the Lord said, put your hands on my chest. And when she did, a ball of fire hit me and knocked me out. I got some folk, the older folk was there, knocked me out, burnt me from the crown of my head to my feet. They had to carry me out. Went to the doctor. He said, I don't understand it. He said, I don't understand it, Brooks, but there's nothing there. I came back, I rejoiced, and I told the folk that I had been delivered. And God said, whosoever I set free, they're free indeed. Don't you bound nobody I set free. He said, let them go. I wouldn't do it. I wouldn't do it. That thing started building up in me again. 5 years, I went. Cancer growing in my body. And the Lord said again, this is the last time I tell you this. And he, Sister, what's her name, Lancaster? Sister Henson, Theodore Henson. And I looked around, I said, there's no Theodore Henson. He said, Satan, stop playing with me. And I looked around, she wasn't there. That 9 o'clock service. 11 o'clock, I couldn't preach. I had other folk preaching for me. 11 o'clock, didn't see her. About 11:30, a head poked up in the back of the glass doors. He said, there she is. I said, oh, Lord Jesus. And I called her down to the front. Same thing happened again. She said, no, no, no. I said, come up here. And she came up. I said, Lord, I said, put your hands in. She did it, and the same thing happened. Knocked the cancer out of my body. Went back to the doctor. He said, Brooks, what is going on with you? You have it, then you don't have it. What is your problem? I said, I don't know. But I came back and the Lord said, now do what I told you. You know, I got the hardest head in the world. I didn't do it. Saints here know I didn't do it. I'm trying to justify who I am, what I'm trying to do. I didn't do it, and guess what? It came back. It came back and grew in my body. They had to take 5 feet of my colon out. And God said, now what you gonna do? I'm gonna do what you said. I released my women. I let them work the altar. I let them wear the pulpit. I had 21 women on my advantage board, and my name is messed up in the way of the cross. But listen, this ain't about way of the cross. This is about the apostolic movement. We are the children of God. If you have a problem, that's your problem. I ain't about to entertain no more cancer because I'm trying to please the people. I'm going to acknowledge the word of God and do it God's way because he's the one. You stand up for who you got to stand up for. I got to stand before God, and I want to hear him say, well done, thou good and faithful. Sir. You've been faithful over a few things, but come on up higher. Oh, I'll make your rulers over many. So you come here and give me a hug. Y'all to stop playing church. Start doing stuff God's way. This ain't no man's church. The way of the cross is not a man's church. It's called the way of the cross, what? Church of Christ. Bible way is Bible way, church of our Lord Jesus Christ. When you start putting all kind of names in about a man, it ain't God's church. God's church is upon this rock. I'll build my church. The gates of hell shall not. I'm about ready to sit down now. Because I want y'all to go home, but I feel something about to bubble over in here. Woo, Jesus. And I know somebody said, I know they got all these Facebook stuff, but I thought he was presiding bishop of the Way of the Cross Church. You know what the Way of the Cross Church stands for. Maybe the Way of the Cross Church do, but I'm standing here tonight with the Pentecostal Apostolic Fellowship, which is God's church. Ain't no man got no rule for the church of the Lord Jesus Christ. God, tell your neighbor, God is in charge. You got to do it God's way. Wake up. Y'all sit down, y'all pushing me. You're pushing me. John Leslie, I don't know if you know this or not, but back in the day when they discriminate
against women preachers, Mother Lena Sears was my father's best friend. You know that. They took pictures together. And folk want to know who is that lady. That's Pastor Sears, the founder of the Church of Jesus Christ. But what they doing together, they were friends. And that was back when he tried to do it Bishop Lawson's way. But he didn't push his friends aside because of denominational preferences. I come out to tell y'all in my closing remarks, the Lord said, upon this rock, I'm going to build my church. Not Brooks Church, not Demery's Church, not Leslie Church, not Fields Church, my church. If it's his church, who's in charge? Tell your neighbor who's in charge. So start doing what God tells you. Y'all ain't hearing me. You're so busy listening to men. You better start listening to the Lord. Say, but the Lord ain't speaking, you miss your calling. Because if you call by the Lord, he speaks to you. If you answer the voice of the Lord tell you what to do. We're so concerned about satisfying men and not satisfying God. I'm about to tell you now, God is on the way back. It won't be long. Signs and times are telling us, God's getting ready to come back. Get your house in order. It's time. Okay, I'm going to get all the call because this thing is bubbling up inside of me. I feel loosed again. I tell you, y'all have no idea how I feel seeing all these pastors and all you out here. They were doing this in Baltimore. I couldn't understand how can Baltimore do a ministerial lounge and we got the same Holy Ghost in Washington and we can't do it. Charles Johnson, I'm so excited that you're in here. I try my best to go and show my fellowship. You know, I was down in Charlotte, North Carolina to Bishop Johnson's convocation. I've been out to New Orleans, Louisiana to John Leslie's convocation. And I'm headed to Greensboro for Charles Johnson's again. And I'm headed back to Detroit for the church, the Pentecostal PCAF. I'm preaching at Bible Ways the fourth week, third week in July. I've traveled across this country. I don't want folks to think Alfonso Brooks is a stuck-up Pentecostal nerd. I'm a child of the Lord Jesus Christ. And guess what? We are brothers and sisters. Hug your neighbor, tell you my sister. We're brothers and sisters. There should be no division. There should be no animosity. There should be no jealousy. It might not be your time, but if you obey the word of God, your time will come. We have been fussing at other people because we look at other denominations and seem like they're busting out of the seams and we can't get our thing together because God ain't playing that division stuff. He called us to be one. Even as we are one, my Father and I are one, I want you to be one. We are one in Christ Jesus. And folk want to talk about, they ask me, how can you be non-denominational? I'm just not. Because man didn't start what I believe. I'm the Church of Jesus Christ, and I'm going to do what God said. Y'all can walk off, turn your back on me, but I'm going to do it God's way. Because at the end of the day, he's the one I got to answer to. At the end of the night, he's the one that put me to sleep. Early in the morning, he's the one that wake me up. But I give him my food. He's allowing me to digest it and all the other things he do. I don't care about you. I love you anyhow, but I'm going to do it God's way. You can have your way, but I'm determined. God is in charge. Okay. It's just too much excitement here to calm down. I don't know. The brothers haven't talked. We have a committee. I don't know how many, 30 some. I hope we can come together and just recoup what we did. And next year, I just think we ought to do it again. If we did it. Listen to me. I do not have to be the man up here. Please know that. With all these preachers we got, I'll take a seat in a New York second and put these preachers up. But we ought to come together. The world needs to understand we're not no little group here, group there. We are the body of the Lord Jesus Christ. You think, oh, they 300 or 400 there, 300 or 400. There are millions of apostolics. The problem is we're divided. We need to come together and let the folk know. If all the apostolics came together, we'd have to go out to RFK Stadium, out of East Capitol Street, or Verizon Center. If we all came together and showed the world we are the body of Jesus Christ, no division. Folk come try to tell me something about the pastor. I don't want to hear it. Yeah, but you ought to hear it. I don't want to hear it. Why? That's my brother. I tell folk all the time, one of my oldest brothers was a gangster. His name was Tuffy Lima. Tuffy Lima. He was in the mafia. I know a lot of y'all didn't know that. My oldest brother was in the mafia. And I went down to Atlanta, Georgia to see him. The big guy in the mafia called him to be his brother. And we talked. Drove all the way to Atlanta, Georgia to see him. We talked and we embraced. My gangster brother and we embracing. You don't hear what I said. My mafia brother and we embrace. But here you and I are born by the same spirit and the Holy Ghost. And we can't even shake each other's hand. Get up out your seat, go hug 3 or 4 people real quick. Just go hug somebody and tell them, I love you, my sister. I love you, my brother. I love the fact that we are one. I love the fact that we are the children of God. I love the fact there's no division. I love the fact we've come together. If they don't want you to hug them, just pat them on the shoulder. Say, I love you anyhow. Oh, Lord, have mercy. Woo. Miracles getting ready to happen in this room. Ready to come all together in one place, on one accord. Suddenly, like a sound from heaven, a rushing mighty wind, it filled all the house where they were sitting. The Holy Ghost is in the room right now. It's getting ready to explode. Just open up your heart to receive it and accept the promise that God has placed upon you. God. I want these bishops and pastors to go down the front. There's somebody here need to be touched. If I get all the pastors in line across this front, bishops, apostles, pastors, come on, wherever you are, if you need someone to touch you for the desire of your heart, you need to run down this aisle and run up to one of these brothers. Just line up across the front. You said, I don't have an oil. Speak blessings in their life. Speak prosperity in their life. Speak the Holy Ghost in their life. Whatever they stand in need of, wherever you are, in the balcony, in the back, you ought to be making your way down this front. Now, don't you last, let this opportunity pass you by. You don't know when you get a chance to be in this kind of power, this kind of anointing in this house. Come on, get your blessing now. Come on, get your blessing, wherever you are. Come on, come on. That's right. Start walking. Walk like you're anxious to get your blessing. Yeah. That's right. Come on, get your blessing. Walk in expectation. Come to receive it. Come to receive it. Walk in faith. Walk in faith. Believe it to receive it. If you believe it, you shall have it. Thank you. That's right. From all over the building, come get your blessing. Come on, get your blessing.